Hello, 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 good morning, wherever you are. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. Today, very quick tutorial. This is all about the painting tool. Really quick, dead simple. So, we're going to kick off with a bit of painting. This is my little test base, my little test ship. You might remember it from the first ever tutorial I did. Well, first thing you want is to get into painting mode. Hold down the right bumper, press down on the D-pad, and you've got a huge amount of colours. Now you can mess around with colours and skins from this menu. And if you've been making lots of different colours, if you want to get them back to the default, just press Y and everything will reset. So, then press B. Now you're in the painting menu. Pushing up on the D-pad and down on the D-pad cycles the colours. Left and right cycles the skins. And you will paint one block at a time by hitting the right trigger, like this, look. And if you want to copy a colour, let's say, I don't know, we paint something green. But you've then painted something over here, and you want to get that exact shade. You've made a custom shade using the menu, but you want to get that exact shade. If you press left trigger on the block that you've just painted, you'll copy that colour across. So now you can paint with that colour or skin. But what happens if you want to paint an area that's a bit different? You want a bigger area rather than one block at a time. Hold down the left bumper and paint. We'll paint six blocks. Six blocks. Change to a different colour. Hold down the right bumper and paint. That will paint a whole area. Of about 12 blocks. But if you wanted this whole platform yellow, then hold down both bumpers, press the right trigger, and it's not just the whole platform, anything connected to that grid is going to change colour, except for the ship that's connected by the connector. Everything else will get painted, so you've thrown a huge can of paint on it, and get that back to normal. This is why I use the default blue and yellow, apart from the fact I really do like the default blue and yellow colour scheme for most things. So, that's your basic paint tutorial. Now, there's one more little trick we can do. You can paint in symmetry mode. Simply select any block you want, press in the right stick, go to symmetry setup, and if you remember my last tutorial video on this, you can go and watch that. You can change the plane of symmetry with down on the D-pad, and when you've got the one you need, lock that plane in with right on the D-pad, and then press up until you get back to the block menu. Now hold down the right bumper, press down on the D-pad, and you're back in the colour menu. Now, what's painted on the left gets painted on the right. Great for symmetrical ships where you want to keep a nice, even colour scheme. Or even better if you want like this. You wanted a red-blue runway, or if I wanted a wanted to colour that ship there, maybe I wanted to put two red stripes, but I didn't want to do it manually. I could do it using symmetry mode. You can paint on every line of symmetry as well, so if you've got more than one set up, you could do it that way. It is really a fairly simple thing to do. And one last trick, or one last point. If you're in paint mode, you'll notice that I get in and out of paint mode fairly quickly. It's because I am, you know, it's second nature to me now to do what I'm doing. But if you hold down the left bumper and press B, you'll take anything off your hand. This also means tools. So if you've got a tool out, hold down left bumper B, take the tool away. You've got a block out, hold down left bumper B, take the block away. Left bumper B is your best friend. It will take you straight back to having nothing in your hands. So that should be everything you need to know about painting with the paint tool, how to go into symmetry mode and paint in symmetry mode with the paint tool, and how to remove the paint tool or any block or tool from your hand. And that's it for this one. So stay tuned, there will be more. As always, if you do think of something in the comments on the channel, feel free to leave me a comment. That'll be great. And I'll catch you in the next video. There may be another one today, depending on if I've got time. I do want to cover some basics on mod.io, but I don't want to link it into this video. I'd rather keep them little separate bite-sized tutorials, so you're not spending all day watching a massive video with a dozen different subjects in it. So, as I always say, take care, stay safe, have fun, happy engineering. Until the next one, bye-bye.